it's been a while, guys. It's been a hot second. But anyways, on to the mod showcase. It does not involve these lockers. Well, it does. These are what's storing all the items we're gonna review. This is the gold gaming lockers, just because they're really big and awesome. I'm also using modded clothes to showcase this, but basically we're going over the mod, the Great Saiku Collection. I'm probably butchering that. I'll probably be butchering a lot of names in this video, so please don't hate on me for it. But before we show you the like completely insane amount of guns, which I can only show you a small fraction of them, let's go over some of the attachments, or at least the ones I can show you on an Eagle Fire. So as you see, there are quite a few sights. There's a number of pods and a bunch of tacticals, and there's actually quite a few barrels, but I can only show a few of them on this. So I guess, and actually some of the attachments, I will say, some of the attachments can't actually spawn in because they have ID conflicts. Mod author, if you are watching this, just know, if I remember, I will have put all the names of them in the description, along with probably their IDs, maybe, I don't know, it's just if I remember. But anyways, why don't we get this thing out a bit and show you. I have no skills on right now. With no skills, the barrel extender doesn't do much in terms of accuracy. You know what it actually is supposed to do. So it increases accuracy, that's the thing. So putting that on, it doesn't do much by itself, but we also have a lot of lasers and lights and all kinds of stuff we can put on. So we can put lights on, but let's actually just put this up like it right quick. So I mean there's plenty of different attachments. They all basically do what you'd expect the laser to do, so let's just use this one. Now these grips are pretty insane. We have the folding grip, and as you see my accuracy, remember, I have no, like, absolutely no skills up right now. Grip pod, which this thing is just overpowered, and this cool little bipod here, which is great for sniping. It's got, I think it looks really cool up here. So let's put the folding grip on here. So now we've got to choose a sight. So this one is honestly my least favorite. I think it just zooms in a little too much. We have the RMR. We also have the SRS, which is a pretty cool one. I do like it. We have one of my favorites, the JH-406. I use this quite often in private servers. We have the Hilux Red Dot Sight, which is pretty cool, I would say. We have the Doctor Sight, which I have not used, and I would definitely use it by anything else. Spectre DR scope, which the scopes in this do actually decrease, like, the update dark. So, oh yeah, it's easy, that's right. We have... Next up, we have the Digital Hunter scope. This one's a cool one, I do like this one. It does look awesome, if you say so myself. Next up, let's go with DCL-10, which I've not seen. And I can see an appeal for it, but I personally think it's a little fat. I'm gonna fat shame this site. Next up, let's go with the Conquest Scope. Actually, that's not bad. That looks pretty cool. I mean, as a sniper scope, I can see somebody getting like, not liking it very much, because there's no lines, but, I mean, if you're good with bullet dropping, you know what gun you're using. You could probably work around that. This is the Compton 2 site. Very common as the other site. Was it? I don't know which site it was. This one. Next to the Seymour Railway site, another one of my favorites. I just love the way this looks. It's got that nice Cobra feel, but with the red dot instead. Next, we have the ACOG. This one's pretty cool. It works just like an ACOG in the other games. I personally love this one. It's one of my favorites in the entire world. We also have the AccuPoint Scope, which I have not seen. But this is actually pretty cool. So this is an even better sniper scope. I think this is a go-to sniper scope if you find one. Next is the Raptors TM Sight. That's not bad. It's a pretty cool one. But I think the dots a little bit. For most of these, I think the dot could be lower. Let's see here, what else? Spectre DR, I think we've already seen, and of course, and that. So yeah, that's, I think that covers just about all the sights. And, no skills. Look how tiny that dot is. That's pretty crazy. Put the APOW down, he's just running off. He's a tripod, just says, look, no skills updated at all. And that's my laser. Just to prove you, look. So this thing, these new attachments can definitely beef out the guns a little bit. So why don't we throw these into here? So I'm gonna grab the happy point. I like it. We're gonna use that to show off some of the snipers. A lot of barrels I can't show you because I don't have the right calibers, but I did want to show you that they do exist. First up, in terms of guns, we have the BR-300. This thing, this is a pretty cool rocket launcher. So let's go find something to blow up. Let's hope this works hard. You don't actually really have to give up all of this thing. Just check that out. It fires basically. This thing basically just fires lasers. What even is this thing? I think that honestly is this cool one. If I do say so myself. Next up we have 600/516 Ranger. There's no very many of this. I'm just judging many machines. Why not? Definitely military. Let's go find some time and do something cool. Alright, well luckily for us, some of them decided to run around this. Wow. That thing, hold on, I have to try this out. Probably shouldn't, but I just have to. Oh, you're so fast! Especially with adaptive triggering. Wow. That is insane. Mon Arthur, just calm down, please. Wow. I mean, I'm not complaining, but wow, that thing fires insanely fast. Okay, now on to the N6 PSD, which is the military, so we'll grab some of that. Let's step one from next. This thing fires at a normal speed, you know, nothing too extraordinary, though I think it would fire incredibly fast at chambering. Yeah, these things can get pretty powerful once you start building the skills in the mix too. But as you see, like, it's not a bad gun. So, I just have terrible aim. Okay. But not a bad gun. It's all these guns are actually pretty cool. They're much more powerful than the bigger guns, but I love how they keep the style pretty decently well, while still kind of staying unique. Now we have this, which this is a great launcher. It just has a bunch of letters and numbers in this game. So that's not right now. It's good. CIS-40GL. Oh, look at that. This is a grenade launcher. Very simple. Scope mount, nice. Let's do it. Oh, cool. Yeah, it doesn't shoot very far, does it? See how far that one goes. That actually went pretty far. So, yeah, I mean, probably be better off using a rocket launcher, but this does stay down a little bit more. Like, it doesn't fly all over the place, or... I mean, I don't know what I'm saying at this point. It's not as big. I don't know what I was saying. But anyways, next we have the Strike. 556. 5.56. I'm not sure why I got the... everything stuff. Oops, a peek. Let's put a different sight on this, because I'm not sure about that sight. Very awesome, and it's very large, and it's very menacing, and I guess you get holes every type. I'm up for it. I'm stuck for it, so... Captain, so I just woke up not too long ago, so my brain's just not working right now. Let's keep the Seymour one in case of things that have other guns. Next, we have the Brand 10, which is a pretty cool one. So the pistols, I will say, my only complaint about the pistols, I love them and all, and hold on the craftsmen and the captains that you need on them. But I don't like the iron sights spacing them at all. I think they're a little too far apart and a little weird looking. But they all the pistols I've used have basically made up pretty much the same. They've all used different mags though. They'll either use Colts, 10mm, or these 10 autos. So 9mm are the most common. So they have all basically the same for all pistols that I've used so far. So, but they're still fun to use. They're great sidearms. So yeah, on to the next gun. Next up, we have the Ruger M77. Now, this is a pretty cool one, actually. I do like this one. I love the way it looks too. So it of course accepts all the attachments you need. It's kind of like a little sharpshooter rifle. It's pretty good too. So you bolt action uses scope with clips, and it handles very similar to the scope. Got some good aim, you can see the targets pretty easily. So yeah, not much to say about the Ruger. I do love it though. And remember, I'm only showing you one weapon from each class, except for the special class. I'm showing you all the special classes. There's only 3 in their own modes, and they're labeled special, so that makes me feel like they have different special treatment. I forgot to take the scope off. Hold on, let me real quick. Next we have the SVK, which is an actual sharpshooter rifle. We use three mags. This is a pretty cool one, if you say so. So I have one of these in my private server. Actually, I have most of those in my private server. I have an entire army with just so many guns in it because they keep picking these things up. I think I'll find something to shoot. Semi-automatic, and just that semi, and it's just a not bad rifle, not bike. Jeez, the scopes are insanely numb. Yeah, skills up, or any grips or anything like that on this, so that covers that. Next on to the Order 12, which is a shotgun. And there's a few of these, and they all, not all of them, but most of them use Vine mags. So let's teleport to Alderton, I guess, to show this one off, because we're running on top of this Stratford. Just to show you, not a bad gun. I haven't used this yet, but there's plenty of guns that use... Oh, actually, I didn't really thought of that. Hold on. I need to try this out. Wow, this fire is super slow. Let's do a deck degree and see how that works. This one works a lot. This isn't bad. So, Seymour Sight doesn't do anything, but Seymour Sight, the deck degree doesn't do much. So, no, that's okay. I'll just put this back. It's a nice, fun gun to use. They're great if you're into CQC. Next up, this one comes with the scope, so you don't have to do much. This is the TAC-50. It's a sniper rifle that uses... Of course, it's a bolt action sniper, which is prison mass. And gravity. Oh well. Look at that. So, it's just a nice little gun. And there's plenty of snipers like this. I probably didn't show you the best. Didn't show you the best I'm going to show you. Next up, we have the Hotchkiss Universal. That's right, so I chose it because it has that easy name. It's right, without any attachments, then we can throw some attachments on it. I can almost use any attachment. First of all, again, no skills. Look at the spray. It's actually not bad. It's a pretty good spray. I'm guessing this is one of those. This is one of those kind of special finding SMGs. Let's throw attachments on it. I thought it was gonna be not very good. This is not good. Jeez. Yeah, we're gonna have to start using this. I'm gonna have to start using more. But yeah, and that's basically all of the standard guns in this mod pack. Or all the types. Now we have these specials. I'm just gonna take all of these out and then go in a bit of a split with these. We got all their ammos in here. So we have a bunch of Nega mags and well, 10 gauge stuff going on here. So let's take this thing out. This is the, I'm gonna butcher all of these, but this is the Yufei Revenge. So let's teleport to, what's it, let's check this out at the military base. I'm not sure what the bullet drop on all this is. I'm not using that right now to show you this. But oh, you just can't take any of these. Okay, so this one has detachments, and that's what you get, I guess. Not bad, actually. Not bad. This one is custom ACOG type. Nope, can't modify this one either. This is an automatic one. And it's a battle rifle. Is that what? First type battle rifle, yeah. Jeez. It doesn't have any burst, which I would have loved to burst, but that's kind of crazy, actually. Pretty powerful. Let me get this dude, this thing is crazy. We also have the Okuni Massacre. Okuni Massacre. I'm gonna take it down. Okuni, I don't know how to pronounce that, okay? I'm sorry. But anyways, let's go find something to take out with this. I think we basically cleared this place out. Here we go. Wow. That fight is pretty decent advanced, I think. Ooh, this thing's fun. This thing's actually really fun. Jeez. Just, wow. I'm trying to find things. I'm not sure where they spawn now, but I'll find some of them on my private server. Wait, I want to try this with flight. Alright, let's try this. He's gone! That was great! Oh dude, this is awesome. This mod's a lot more fun now. But anyways guys, that is it for this Lieutenant Diamond video. If you liked it, please like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.